of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of the King rise among us. Let it rise. Let the songs of the Lord rise among us. Let the songs of the Lord rise among us. Let the joy of the King rise among us. Let it rise. Oh, let it rise. Oh, 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 let it rise. Oh, 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 let it rise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
Welcome to our celebration today as we celebrate the sixth Sunday in Ordinary Time. A special welcome to our visitors joining us from your homes, and we're hoping that soon we'll be able to come together in person. As we begin this celebration, let us pause now to place ourselves in God's hands, calling to mind God's great love, and asking for forgiveness for any times that we have sinned. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who teach us that you abide in hearts that are true and just, grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron, saying, when someone has on the skin of their body a swelling or an eruption or a spot, and it turns into a leprous disease on the skin of their body, that person shall be brought to Aaron, the priest, or to one of his sons, the priests. Anyone who has the leprous disease shall wear torn clothes and let their hair on their head be disheveled, and shall cover their upper lip and cry out, unclean, unclean. That person shall remain unclean as long as the disease persists, and being unclean, such a one shall live alone with their dwelling outside the camp. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
taste and see the goodness of God, goodness of God. Taste and see the goodness of God, goodness of God. I will bless the Lord, I will sing forever to glorify Him. The humble and lowly will hear and be glad when I sing, when I sing. Taste and see the goodness of God, goodness of God. Taste and see the goodness of God, goodness of God. Magnify the Lord, let us sing together, exalting His name. Oh, I sought the Lord and He rescued me from every fear, every fear. Taste and see the goodness of God, goodness of God. Oh, taste and see the goodness of God, goodness of God. If we look to the Lord, we will shine with joy, and we never will hang our head in shame. We'll never be the same. Taste and see the goodness of God, goodness of God. Oh, taste and see the goodness of God, goodness of God.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do everything for the glory of God. Give no offense to Jews or to Greeks or to the Church of God. Just as I try to please everyone in everything I do, not seeking my own advantage, but that of many, so that they may be saved. Be imitators of me as I am of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Deacon Cyril, may the Lord be in your heart and on your lips, that you may wordily proclaim His holy gospel in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. A man with leprosy came to Jesus begging him. And kneeling, he said to Jesus, "If you choose, you can make me clean." Moved with pity, Jesus stretched out his hand and touched him. And he said to him, "I do choose, be made clean." Immediately the leprosy left him, and he was made clean. After sternly warning Jesus sent him away at once, saying to him, "See that you say nothing to anyone, but go show yourself to the priests and offer your cleansing, what Moses commanded, as a testimony to them." But the man went out and began to proclaim it freely, to spread the word, so that Jesus could no longer go into the town openly. But he stayed out in the country, and the people came to Jesus from every quarter. The Gospel of the Lord.
One of the most inspiring stories I've heard in my life, I read when I was in grade 11. It was the story of Father Damien de Wooster, perhaps better known as Damien the Leper, or today known as Saint Damien of Molokai. Father Damien was born in Belgium in 1840. Leprosy was then, as in biblical times, a very feared and deadly skin disease. Today, leprosy is referred to as Hansen's disease, after the doctor who discovered an effective treatment for it. But people in Father Damien's time who contracted the disease were sent off to a remote and desolate leper colony on a Hawaiian island called Molokai, where they would suffer and die, sadly cut off from family and friends and the rest of the world, so as not to infect others. Father Damien volunteered to go to the island, knowing that he would probably never be allowed off, to minister to the people there, taking care of not only their spiritual needs and building four churches on the island, but helping provide them with food and water and taking care of their wounds. He successfully petitioned for and welcomed a group of religious sisters to assist him in caring for the people, all of whom were sick and dying. Though healthy when he first arrived, Father Damien eventually contracted leprosy himself and died of the painful disease. He was canonized, or declared a saint, in 2009 by Pope Benedict XVI. His story and his heroic charity to those in need was a great inspiration to me in wanting to become a priest. In today's readings, we hear quite a bit about leprosy. Our first reading from Leviticus gives us a sense that not only does a person with leprosy suffer with a physically painful disease that leads to death, but suffers the pain of being cut off from society. We heard, "Anyone who has the leprous disease shall wear torn clothes, and let the hair of their head be disheveled, and shall cover their upper lip, and cry out, 'Unclean, unclean.' That person shall remain unclean as long as the disease persists, and being unclean, such a one shall live alone with their dwelling outside the camp." In today's gospel, a man with leprosy begs Jesus for healing. Jesus is moved with compassion for the man, touches him when most feared to touch lepers, and says to him, "I do choose, be made clean," and he heals him. Ironically, after healing the man, Jesus, and no longer the leper, is the one who couldn't go into a town openly, but stayed out in the country, as so many people were coming to him. We are reminded of Jesus taking on our sins and the punishment for our sins by his dying on the cross for us. I can't help but see connections between our current COVID-19 pandemic and the leprosy talked about in our readings today. Both involve a deadly disease with suffering more extensive than simply physical, but involving isolation and being cut off from normal interactions with other people. We are reminded that Jesus can not only restore one's physical health, but can restore our relationships to the community, and most importantly, he wants to restore our relationship to God. We should follow the example of today's gospel and come to Jesus begging him, kneeling down and saying, "If you choose, you can make me clean." Or we can put it in our own words, what it is we are in need of at this particular time in our lives, trusting that God desires to bring us healing and peace. We also recognize that healing comes in many forms, and that there are higher levels of healing than simply physical healing, such as the healing of our relationship with God, healing of our relationships with others, and experiencing the inner peace that comes with that. Our reaching out to help others can be a great help to us as well. We are about to start our season of Lent this Wednesday, February the 17th, with Ash Wednesday. This is a penitential season of 40 days to bring us closer to God, especially through works of prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. Two recommendations you may wish to consider. One, we will be having a one-night virtual Lenten mission with Chris Bray, an award-winning singer and songwriter and Catholic speaker who has presented to us different missions in the parish already. And this will be online only during Lent. So stand by for more information on that event. Secondly, several people in the last few weeks have talked to me about a podcast called Bible in a Year by Ascension Press. So I began it last week, and I'm really enjoying it. Over the course of 365 days, you will read the entire Bible. Each day's podcast is only about 20 minutes long, reading small sections from about three books of the Bible for about 10 minutes. Then Father Michael Schmidt gives a brief reflection for about 10 minutes. I am thoroughly enjoying it and seem to gain some new insight every day from Father Michael's reflection. I'm trying to do two or three podcasts a day until I get caught up. So you may wish to consider doing something like that as well. Google Bible in a Year and you should be able to find it quickly. Or go to ascensionpress.com, and it is Father Michael Schmidt who does the readings and gives a short reflection each day. As we continue with this celebration of the sixth Sunday of Ordinary Time, let us thank God for sending us Jesus, who reaches out to us in our brokenness and pain to touch us and bring us hope and healing. He reaches out to us today to restore our relationship both with God, our loving Father, and with one another, and to bring us the gift of his peace.
We stand as we profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us now turn to God with our prayers of petition. Let us pray for the Church throughout the world. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for his health and for his intentions. For all of our leaders in the church and for all the people of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for peace throughout the world and for a greater love and respect for life in all of its stages. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those affected by the COVID virus in whatever way, for God's healing and God's peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for the staff and students of our schools who have returned recently to classes. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are sick, all those who are suffering, especially for those who are dying. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for a good and fruitful period of Lent beginning shortly. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, that they may enjoy eternal peace in Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now pause for a moment in silence to bring our own prayers and needs and those of our families and friends before God. Lord God, in faith and in trust, we bring these prayers and all of our needs before you. We ask you to hear these, to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Oh, Jesus Christ, you are my one desire, my one desire, my one desire. Oh, Jesus Christ, you are my one desire, my one desire, my one desire. I want to know you more. I want to love you more. I want to hunger more for you. I want to know you more. I want to love you more. I want to hunger more for you. Oh, Jesus Christ, you are my one desire, my one desire, my one desire. Oh, Jesus Christ, you are my one desire, my one desire, my one
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May this oblation, O Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us, and may it become for those who do your will the source of eternal reward, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Ronald Peter, our Bishop, Joseph, his auxiliary, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
precious Father, tell me what good have I done this gift you offer, that of your precious Son, and yet before his real presence now I feel I am not worthy, I am bruised and I am bent, I am so worldly, and you are so heaven sent, sent from the Father, from so pure and so holy, except for he, except for he, except for he. I can't believe it, that you would shed your blood and I receive it. I who was once a broken cup, but now I'm healed, but now I'm
Let us pray. Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for that food by which we truly live, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Have a great week. Hope to see you soon. God bless.
Higher than mountains that I face, stronger than the power of the grave,
constant in the trial and the change. One thing remains, 'cause your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love. And on and on and on and on it goes. It overwhelms and satisfies my soul. And I never ever have to be afraid, 'cause one thing remains, 'cause your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your love never fails, never gives up, never runs out on me. Your